Welcome, everyone. This is my first Sunday night EFT tapping ambient music jam and hangout. So yeah, please say hello in the comments if you're watching on any of the platforms that I'm streaming to. I'd love to hear from you. And yeah, let me know your thoughts. Let me know if there's, if this is a good time on Sundays, or if you would prefer another time. And in the meantime, let's just hang out. I'm gonna turn this bass up a little bit. If you have any, interest in hearing about this instrument or my patch or my process, please feel free to ask questions. And yeah, if you have speakers, if you have a sub pack or a gaming chair, definitely feel free to turn that on. Part of the reason why I got into creating this kind of music is using bass as a sound healing tool, which is kind of what has ultimately led me to building all of this. So, this patch for a while, and then at about 7 o'clock we're gonna do some tapping. If you have any questions about EFT or tapping or meditation, I'm here and I'm available to answer any questions that anybody has.
Thank you.
a fun journey over the last few months to take everything that I've learned from several years of music production and turn it into this. This right here is one of my favorite modules right now because you can just resample into it. It makes things sound really cool. You can sort of change the pitch. I like these weird pitch bends. Some of you may know I've been working to create digital media a lot over the last few years. I started from nothing. Like 3.5-4 years ago, I knew absolutely nothing about technology and computers and cameras and now I finally have this beautiful setup built that I am so grateful to get to share. Sometimes I like to make these little glittery noises. Let's see if we can catch some of them. makes the teeniest loops of sound ever known to human, called microsound. And they sound like little glitters when you catch them right. There they are. Yeah. I love that. So yeah, a lot of why I'm starting to do this series is because I really, really, I'm excited about teaching meditation and EFT. I really think if I would have learned those skills when I was younger, man, I would have been able to do so much more. But I mean, I really think at any age, it's a game changer to be able to like reprogram your mind and change any patterns that you get stuck in. I mean, not that I never get stuck. I still get stuck. I'm still human, I'm still a person. But yeah, there's a way through. And for me, tapping and EFT has just been so pivotal in my life, as well as meditation. And I'm really grateful to get to share them, but a huge part of all of this for me is just like couldn't happen without music. Music is such an integral part of my life, of who I am, of how I was introduced to these practices. Burning Man and festivals influenced me really, really deeply. And I learned a lot of tools at festivals for self-healing. I'm so grateful that I get to share them with other people.
Thank you.
more glitter tones going from the morphogen. We'll grab this tiny piece of audio. Create this micro loop and bend it up. Some glitter sauce. Exciting things to me about synthesis and about all of the spaghetti of chords here. Is that you kind of know what it's gonna do, but you don't always really know. Like I could kind of like create the parameters for it to do the things. Like all those super cool grumbles in the background. I had no idea those were gonna be there. I love that. Oh, it's starting to get a little darker in here. Get a little more light.
No.
things. Like those note bends. just getting here. We're just hanging out and vibing. In about 15 minutes, 10 or 15 minutes, we're going to do some EFT tapping. It's going to be a very introductory, super easy, super chill. Enjoy some music in the background. For now, I'm just digging these little alien sounds.
Thank you.
to be listening to music for about 5 more minutes before I start leading some EFT. The music will still be going in the background, but until then, feel free to say hi in chat or just relax and enjoy the music. hopefully my levels are good and you can hear me all right. Thank you so much for joining me here tonight for this ambient music, and I'm so grateful to those of you who have been attending these. This is my first week streaming, and I'm really just overwhelmingly grateful to finally be doing this. You know, I started off with no knowledge about technology a handful of years ago, and have slowly built my way into audio engineering, video, and now streaming, so it's just a real pleasure to get to share this with you guys. And this is just the first week of many. I've got a schedule up on my Twitch. If you're watching this on Facebook or YouTube, you're always welcome to engage there, but if you want to check my schedule out, it is on my Twitch page. I lead meditations every Monday and Wednesday morning at 8 a.m. Eastern, and I'm going to be doing every Sunday evening ambient music and EFT. If you have requests like time slots or subject matters, I'm really easy to reach out to. I love hearing from y'all. So yeah, please let me know if you have any requests. If you haven't done tapping before, this is going to be just a really basic little intro. So to start, just going to start tapping. There's one point on either side where your collarbone meets your sternum. And I like to take and make a little C shape with my hand. And just really lightly start tapping on both sides. You can use your whole hand to tap. You really just want to tap very lightly. And allow your body just relax. What EFT is, stands for Emotional Freedom Technique. And it's been around for over 20 years now. It is a technique that is used in psychotherapy. It's been very thoroughly researched and documented. It's used to treat severe PTSD, trauma, anxiety, but it has a whole wide range of applications. And it's sort of like a combination of a bunch of different methods. So it uses acupressure points from the Chinese meridian system, and that's what we're tapping on right now. And we're going to go through a whole sequence, but we'll go ahead and move to the outside of the hand. So just on the outside edge of your hand here, I like to use three fingers. There's just on this flat part here, the whole side of your hand. You can use one finger if you want, right in the middle, or you can use, I like to use three. Some people use all four fingers. And this spot is called a reversal point because it's right in between the positive and negative sides of your energy field. And it's sort of like a point that gets used a lot of the time when beginning sessions, although it's in the main sequence also. So beyond the tapping, in EFT, there's sort of like, if you're being led or guided, there's a call and response where the person who is guiding will say a statement like, let's say if we're gonna focus on something simple, so I think the feeling of overwhelm is something that has been coming up lately for folks, for me as well. So if we're doing this on overwhelm, and if you're feeling something else, you know, you can insert whatever emotion you want here, but you would make a statement like, even though I'm feeling really overwhelmed, and then you would follow it with a statement that's affirming, I deeply and completely accept myself. And you can do it in your head, although a lot of the research has suggested that, you know, we stay more focused on our statement, and it can feel more real when it is said out loud. So just something to be aware of. And we're going to come and tap on the inside corner of the eyebrows. And you can do both sides with one hand. You can do two hands. And you can just do one hand on either side. Any way you want to do it is fine. You don't have to be exact, but you know, get as close as you can. And if you ever have any questions about where points are, just let me know in the chat. And then we're going to come to the outside of the eye. So right here. Just kind of right in line with the outside corner of your eye on the bone there. That's where the next point is. And just go ahead and take a deep breath in through your nose. And out through your mouth. And then we're going to come under the eye. So right in line with your pupil. And you can feel around. There's a little notch where the bone plates in your face meet. And that's the point that we're looking for. Some people it's a little lower. Some people it's a little higher. It just depends on your anatomy. So in a lot of sort of new agey and healing oriented spaces, there's a lot of focus put on, you know, what are you manifesting with your words and that sort of thing. We're going to tap under the nose next. But when it comes to EFT, we really want to go towards the discomfort. We want to go towards the feeling that's challenging. And we're going to tap under the lips, right in the cleft of your chin. We don't want to deny what we're feeling, because the way out is through, is sort of like this approach. So it's like acknowledging what's bad, acknowledging what's hard, and then giving ourselves love and compassion and acceptance. And back to the collarbones. So you would say, even though I'm feeling really overwhelmed, I deeply and completely accept myself. Take a deep breath. And then I'm going to tap right in line with the center of your pec, on the side of your ribs, under your arm. Where you would say why you're feeling overwhelmed. I'm feeling really overwhelmed because, and then you would say why you're feeling overwhelmed. You can give a whole list here. And then after you're done with your list or saying why, you would say an affirming statement. Even though I'm feeling really overwhelmed, I deeply and completely accept myself. Side. that's a very brief intro to EFT. I really appreciate you coming by. The music is going to stay on for a while, so please relax and enjoy. And I hope you have a beautiful Sunday, and to see you on the next stream. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.